What is that?
The mineral planet crate.
That's a rebel base?
Abandoned, but heavily armed.
It's a little bit too early for celebrations, isn't it?
They're coming. Shut the door.
Oh, those crystal wolves. Those crystal foxes.
Incoming!
No, don't! No! Finn! Rose! You're not dead!
Is this all that's left?
Almost.
Oh, I'm so glad to see you!
Use whatever power we've got left to broadcast a distress signal to the Outer Rim.
Huh. Chrome dome down? I think if the level would have worked well, if there wouldn't be any bugs, it would still be a pretty stressful and uncontrollable and uncommon level. And I'm not even talking about the dialogues anymore. I think in cases of storytelling and comedy and everything, they are following the levels pretty tightly. The movies pretty tightly, with cutting out so much dialogue that actually helps to understand what's going on. So it just can't be good. This is maybe at the end, when we are done with this game, when we are done with the last episode, I will talk a little bit more about that part, about everything. Maybe I will give a little recap about the entire game. But for now, like, when playing the sixth episode, the game started to disappoint me, and it hasn't stopped. There were levels that were fun, but like playing episode 4 and 5, the game just kept on going amazingly. And then that broke down really, really quickly and really, really fast, and that's way too sad. Yeah, glad I did that. I guess I have to get all the power to launch this distress signal. Couldn't I have just done that from the start and maybe not needing to get to this one point to continue the story? It didn't even trigger a cutscene, it was just unnecessary. Was it wrong of me to get up here? Yes, it was. Just needed to pass to walk past this guy that would make me unlock Admiral Akbar.
We gotta get this distress signal out quick, but the dish has got no power, and it's facing the wrong way. Could you help us out?
Of course, because I'm the only one who's actually doing something here.
From that one. It's not doing much anyway. Now we've got it turned on. Do you know how this thing works? I left the manual back on the radis.
I guess I just have the buttons when I have the chance.
Hey, looks like we got it up and running. Good job. But the dish itself is a bit broken. You think you could get on the roof and fix it?
Of course I can. Wait, no, this is a little bit too cheap. Do I now really have to just get... Do I now really have to get any astromech? Then I could just also use R2-D2. That's cheap. That is not even a riddle to make me get an astromech in whichever way ever possible.
It's all working. We did it. Great teamwork, guys. The distress signal is being transmitted. Imagine if no one responds. I'm sure they will. I'm not worried.
They will respond, definitely.
Finn, come up here. You're gonna want to see this.
Up there? I thought I would be the one being up. And I'm not Finn, I'm R2-D2. The game made me switch... Where am I? Okay. The game made me switch characters, so no, I'm not Finn anymore.
Oh, this? This is easy.
Building it up. Oh, so there... No, wait. Even though there was a way to just get an astromech from down there up here, it's still... There wouldn't be any astromech in my team anyway, so why? Yeah, they said it. Well, there's still more for me to do. Really stretching out this one scene where I just had to get... Oh, interesting. Where I just had to get the distress signal out. Putting in pretty much... Just a lot of stuff. Ah, okay. Is this what LEGO has become? There wasn't even a console here. And I wasn't the one who destroyed it. It wasn't there from the beginning. What did happen to LEGO games? Aww, but they are cute. I love them.
Here.
Crystal foxes.
We gotta take out that cannon.
You think? No. Yeah, that's pretty much what the scene was.
All right, ground forces, lay down some fire. Rose, you got three right behind you.
I can't lose them.
Okay, the girl survived.
She's hurt pretty bad.
Luke.
I'm sorry.
I know. I'm just glad you're here. At the end.
The cubes from the Millennium Falcon.
Skywalker's doing this so we can survive.
Aww, I hope they are playable characters. I hope they are
Follow
playable
me.
Characters.
Did you come back to say you forgive me? To save my soul?
No.
No. I will try to do this as much. Oh, I can't even die. This is just a quick time event.
How are you doing that? I
Oh, okay,
you.
That's nice. Okay, I don't really have to fight him. That's cool. I just
Fire
have to obliterate him.
Have. Understood. Fire!
But I don't get it. Okay, that this scene is included in a level is really precious.
I'm sorry.
I'm sure you are.
I thought he wouldn't be apologizing. But actually, I can't understand why this part with the speeders... pressing the wrong buttons.
Learn some
why this
tricks.
Part with the speeders wasn't the level. Why they take out Finn trying to sacrifice himself and then being saved
Fire!
By Rose, which is like the only good scene Finn has in this entirety of the movie. But that's kind of cute. That's a nice level interpretation of this scene. But there was just...
Resistance is dead. The war is over. And when I end you...
There are just so many interesting parts
Jedi.
About this game,
Amazing.
About this film that
Every
you could put into a game.
Just said,
but they don't.
Wrong.
But they just mess it up somehow. They just don't do it. And I don't understand
My
why. And why am I pressing
on?
The wrong buttons all the time. And even though this level is pretty amazing, that it's really not you fighting, just no matter what, but you dodging, it's just a long quick time event. Nah, difficult decision. Building a crystal, Kylo Ren. Neat.
I see going into hiding didn't slow you down. No matter.
I didn't go into hiding. I was taking a well-earned rest after destroying the Empire.
Your resilience is almost admirable and incredibly frustrating.
I come admire us some more. Okay, maybe I have to explain why I was messing it up so much before. But the buttons that the screen showed are actually not the buttons on my controller.
The war is just beginning, and I will not be the last Jedi.
That was nice.
There has to be a natural opening that's not on any of the maps.
That was cool, since it was not just me fighting like in every other scene. And they included that Luke got shot so many times in the level and not just in the cutscene, which I almost didn't expect. I almost expected they just left it out completely, which they did with a lot of stuff in those games, in those episodes. So I am surprised in a good way. But there's a lot of stuff that this level can't really make right.
No,
oh no.
Gone.
We can find another way around. We know which direction it's heading at least.
Not in the best position.
What? Build a new drill bit, replace the battery. It'll be good as new.
Yeah,
I'm in charge, right? Nothing to worry about. Yeah.
But if you would actually be able to play one of those foxes, if those crystal foxes are playable characters, everything would be alright again. I would love this game again. Oh, it's a grid. Couldn't we actually just take the TNT? The dynamite? Oh no, it explodes directly. I kind of didn't realize that I'm still inside of a level, so I didn't really take much care of looking around and collecting money.
Okay.
I don't feel like doing that right now. Boxing glove, drill, mining. The boxing glove drill sounds like more fun. It's really just a boxing glove. That's okay. What did I expect? Let's see if we can punch our way through. Am I actually getting to control this?
Told you, good as new. I wouldn't say new.
Okay, no, I'm not actually to control this. I just have to hold this. Great gameplay. Great gameplay. Okay, this is kind of cool. Follow me, guys. Okay, now it's working. That's creative. That's neat. That is actually really a salt crystal cave. But I'm wondering if they are explaining that this rule is actually breaking down. That they get to be saved by Rey. Nope, it's not even breaking down. They're just subusing it. Hello, little fox. This actually feels like an original episode from a Lego game. Like, it's long, you have several passages, you change scenes, you are in a long tunnel. This is the first level that really feels like an original episode again. Which is not a criticism. It doesn't have to feel like the old Lego games. But it does.
Hello?
Hello. Ray! The hero everyone was waiting for.
Strike me down in anger and I'll always be with you. Just like your father.
What did the salt look like blood? It's still working.
Not now. Go away. Just
Just come back later. Thank you.
No.
I cleaning
See
now.
See you around, kid. No!
And he's dead. And they don't care that one of the most powerful Jedi's ever just died like that. Shuri reading the text from the Jedi.
Luke is gone. I felt it.
Ow. I felt it too.
How do we build a rebellion from this?
We have everything we need. Right here.
Oh, my instruction manual. But yeah, that's actually a pretty good question, like... That kid just got smacked into a pile of feces. And it's a kid's game. He's wearing the Resistance merchandise. Really, this scene had to end with oppression? Seriously? Nah. I kind of lost it anyway. But yeah, the end of the 8th episode kind of doesn't make really sense. They are celebrating, they are like, oh, we have so much hope, there are 5 of you left, and the Resistance is the Millennium Falcon at this point. Okay, yeah, we have still hope. And now... It's kind of confusing, or kind of a bad decision I made. You are not supposed to end something on a bad note, but the 9th Star Wars movie is the one I like the least. Like, I really don't dislike the 8th movie that much, but the 9th movie is just not to my liking at all. So, let's see how much I will criticize this time. A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. Star Wars. If you can't read that. Episode 9. The Rise of Skywalker. The dead speak. The galaxy has heard a mysterious broadcast, a threat of revenge, and the sinister voice of the late Imperial Palpatine. General Leia Organa dispatched secret agents to gather intelligence, while Rey, the last hope of the Jedi, trains for battle against the diabolical First Order. Meanwhile, Supreme Leader Kylo Ren rages in the search of the Phantom Emperor, determined to destroy any threat to his power. Determined to destroy any threat of his power, yeah, Kylo Ren's power. I should start thinking. Ooh, let's see. Big ship. Every Star Wars movie has to start with a big ship. It doesn't start with Kylo Ren killing a lot of guys to get the Sith Holocron.
Last, my boy, I have been every voice
you have ever heard
inside your head.
The dark side of the Force is a pathway to many abilities some consider to be unnatural.
Oh.
What could you give me?
Everything. A new Empire. A new Empire. Find the girl. End the Jedi. And become what your grandfather Vader could not.
Sidious looks disturbing. T-5.
Bulio, good to see you. You got something for us?
From a new ally. A spy in the First Order. Transfer the message! Get it to Leia!
Is it working? Oh,
we're
no.
about to be cooked!
Poe, we got it!
They couldn't have detached the cable before all this happens. Is this going to be the first level? Yes, it is.
I need those ties out of the way if I'm gonna get us out of here.
To be honest, you are kind of already able to tell when the new level is going to start or not because of the way the cutscenes are cut. Which way to take? Come on, if Wei could fly through a Star Destroyer, the best pilot in the galaxy, Poe Dameron can't fly through this part. This just looks really not like Lego anymore. Except for the Millennium Falcon, but the environment just looks like it's game texture. Let's follow him. I want him dead. You need to go. Neat! Might not get to 100% in every situation here, but at least we got one minikit. And another one down. Oh, welcome.
Good thinking, Chewie.
Ben, we can hold her these ties.
I was just thinking that.
I was just about to say that this level is kind of boring since it's all the same all the time for a long period. Or for something that just feels like a long period of time. And I guess it still is. If this level is not ending now, or if nothing happens. Hey, something happens!
Alright, let's make the jump to light speed.
Wow. Okay, nothing really happens. But Finn has a new haircut.
What are you doing? Light speed skipping! How do you know how to do that?
Cool interpretation of the movie scene. No questions here.
Yeah,
but not
here.
That entertaining to play. Kind of just being bored here. Am I getting money every time I don't mess up the quick time event? I think I am.
Don't care.
But this looks beautiful.
Hold on!
And at least the environment is nice. Oh, we know this guy. And we know this guy. And we're back. Rektar. The Rektar has taken the ship.
Be with me. Be with me. Be with me.
They're not with me.
Oh. You're trying too hard, Ray. Just let go. Let
Ray,
them reach
be
you.
Patient. I'm gonna run the training course.
That's not patience. A skip and a jump. Hey, we finished this level pretty good, actually. Ooh, wait, episode 9 is actually Jedi now. And a red C-3PO. Why do I like the colored version of C-3PO so much more than the golden version? Like, not from personality traits or something like, but just from the looks of it. The colored versions, like the pink one, the red one we have already seen so far, they look really nice. Is this a training course? Huh. Let's just really run the training course like we would be training and not stopping to gather money from plants. And the green one!
Keep going, Ray.
Yeah, keep going, Ray. Sorry, sorry, I shouldn't have stopped. Neat! I got the flag. Okay, this is kind of fun. It really kind of reminds me of Dagobah, where you also had this training course with Luke. Well, it's actually exactly the same situation, so it's no wonder it would remind me of that. But those scenes are done well. They are fun. Maybe not really that difficult. Oh, I actually have to swing. Oh, and now the lightsaber climbing. Which I'm still really unsure if this is practical kill. I can't imagine that this is useful or practical in any way. But we shall see.
I have to keep going.
Yes, you have to keep going with this really long training scene. Oh, now it's over. It doesn't look as destroyed as it is in...
Join me.
Join me, join me, join me.
Ray! Falcon's back!
Hey! You girl telling me stuff without moving your lips. And I know this is not a bad critic, like, it's okay if they're not using their lips, but it's unregular in this LEGO game. Normally they use their lips to talk. Or maybe I just haven't seen it.
I need another one in the back! Go! Go!
Continue the story.
There's a mole in the First Order and they sent us a message.
Somehow Palpatine returned. He's been planning his revenge. The largest fleet the galaxy's ever known. Hiding in the unknown regions, on a world called Exegol.
Luke searched for it. He said to get there you need one of these. A Sith Wayfinder. I'm gonna start where his trail went cold. The Forbidden Desert of Bassana.
We go together.
At least the dialogue not seem that cheesy anymore. It kind of makes sense.
Chewie, get that compressor fixed? Alright, then let's head to Bassana.
Okay, considering how this Falcon was just burning a second ago, that looks pretty fine to me. Let's go to the sauna to just say what Poe Dameron pretty clearly said a few seconds ago. The Forbidden Valley. And I don't like that the characters are spawning on the map before the ship lands. I just have to say this now, this just disturbs me so much. Like, you could have saw Finn already on the planet before. Before the ship actually landed, and then he despawned. And the game registered that he actually wasn't supposed to be there yet. I'm glad I took a speeder for that one.
What is this?
The Aki Aki Festival of the Ancestors.
It's the festival. Kind of don't look that as crowded as in the movie, but that's okay. Twi'leks! I really like Twi'leks. Or are they called Twi'leks?
I've never seen anything like this.
I've never seen so few wayfinders.
Finn, so, be optimistic.
What now?
We talk to people. Maybe find out what drew Luke here.
Break apart? Why am I able to just do that? Why is this a possibility? But I love that C-3PO is leaving those tracks behind. They really look like the... how a Lego figure is looking from underneath. That's really cool. Okay, let's ask around a little bit if we actually can find a Sith Wayfinder. If someone just knows about a Sith Wayfinder somewhere around here.
It's nice to look up at the sky and see kites flying around instead of First Order ships coming to get me and my family. This whole festival really takes my mind off their galaxy-wide occupation, you know?
I hope it works. I'm glad it works. Have a nice time. You are an optimist. I like you. Just do what makes you happy and live your happy life. I am one kind of person where distraction almost never works. If I have a problem, I won't be happy until I have solved this problem. and I can't really distract myself from it, so...
Don't know if you can tell, but I'm not from around here. I suggest talking to a local. They look like the knowledgeable types.
Yeah, I would guess the fish is not really common in the desert world.
That weird hermit keeps ruining my vibe. Bumbling around with his mask on, muttering Ochi this and Ochi that. Wish he would just Gochi away.
Nice one. Nice one. But those informations are not really worth anything.
Oh, my neck feels bare. All other outsiders have those beautiful necklaces on. Where do I get one of those?
Just be kind and ask around.
Let's try asking a local.
Yeah, why did we not do that from the start? Let's actually play someone I like. Let's play Poe Dameron. The best character they included with the new movies, in my opinion. Even though he doesn't really have a character arc. But that's on the movie and not on the character. They fly now! Oh, of course, they made the level that name.
What did he? Nambigima.
Her name is Nambigima.
That's an excellent name. I'm Ray.
You can't hide, Ray.
Oh.
What? It's the mask, isn't it?
Or the shirt.
I'm going to find you, and I'm going to turn you to the dark side.
We'll see.
My knights and I are going hunting for the scavenger.
We have to go back to the Falcon. Now.
Leia sent me a transmission.
General Calrissian, we're looking for Exegol.
Luke and I were tailing an old relic hunter, Ochi of Bestum. He was carrying a clue that could lead to a wayfinder. Only two were made. We followed his ship halfway across the galaxy. It was abandoned, out past Lurch Canyon. I've got a bad feeling about this.
Mm-hmm. We've spotted the fugitive.
Go!
There! Those speeders!
Let's go! The dialogue is still cheesy.
We have to get to Ochi's ship!
Maybe not shooting my own guys. That would be nice. This is not easy to aim. Especially not with...
They fly now!
They have been flying since the Clone Wars! Can I aim with this? No, I can't, just drop it. What is even happening?
Calm down,
what is happening?
I'll get us out of this.
That doesn't fill me with as much confidence as you think, sir.
Nobody cares about you, 3PO. Okay, this literally does not make sense at all to shoot the speeders. But I'd like that they get pushed back every time I shoot the guy through the jetpack. That actually makes it feel like I have somewhat of control.
OG's ship! I've seen that ship before.
Try to grab something!
Will this agony ever end?
No!
No!
That might just already be the level.
Where are the others?
Let's find them.
Yes, that's already the level. Of course the cave system wouldn't be turned into a level, of course. Why would they make an interesting part?
They have to be in these tunnels somewhere.
We'll find them. I'm sure of it.
It's really dark down here without the flashlight. Oh, that was just because this was a dead end. It's really not dark down here without a flashlight.
Ben! Oh!
You didn't say my name, sir, but I'm all right.
C-3PO, just stop being a bit about that, okay? Oh. I'm not a scavenger anymore,
so... You helped make a route across there.
No net shooter acquired. This feels more like a level than the passage before. This was not necessarily what I wanted to do. Oh. Okay. Co-op parts without co-op just don't feel right. This doesn't feel right either.
Didn't just feel the ground move.
I felt it move, sir.
Can it, 3PO?
No, thank you.
You seem to know your way around this place.
How would everyone ever know? How? Like, no. This is just a cave. No one could actually know their way around this place. What is it supposed to mean, Finn? It's just a cave. Okay, now Poe should be able to get up here. Yep. Since a normal character can jump as high up as a Jedi, everything is fine.
I do not want to know what made these tunnels.
Judging by the circumference of the tunnel walls, that
I said I do not want to know. Not.
That were just ribs, weren't there? A rib case. I just destroyed a rib case. And Poe is worried about the tunnels. And this is a spine! Oh my god.
Bones. I don't like bones.
Boom. Never a good sign.
Well, actually.
We were goners.
We might still be.
Which way out?
This way. We have to hurry.
We're not seeing this giant snake directly in front of you.
Speeder. Guess we're not the first ones to end up down here.
Yep. The snake and the dagger. It's like, oh, that's cute. It's Frodo's dagger from Lord of the Rings.
Horrible things have happened with this.
There's writing on it.
Oh, I know exactly where the Wayfinder is. Unfortunately, I am mechanically incapable of speaking translations from Sith.
Yeah, the snake is.
Serpent! Serpent!
Aw, a little bandage.
I just transferred a bit of life. Force energy from me to him.
We gotta keep moving to find someone who can translate that dagger like a helpful droid.
No way you didn't just transfer your life to him. You just gave him a bandage.
I suggest we return to the Millennium Falcon at once.
They'll be waiting for us at the Falcon. I got a better idea.
We cannot possibly fly out in that old wreck.
We don't really have an option, 3PO.
Am I going to sink in this? No. It's just getting harder to move around. Oh, this is a way back into the caves. Okay, this is kind of cool. I like this. This is kind of cool. One thing that doesn't make any sense about this is that C-3PO was presumably built by by Anakin Skywalker, a kid, slave. Like, C-3PO was built from Anakin when he was just, I don't know, shortly before he was taken from Qui-Gon, where he was like, I don't know, 10 years old, 12 years old. And he built C-3PO. I don't think that a slave would know to build a protocol droid to not translate from a fifth language. Maybe he just downloaded the software from somewhere else. That's why he can't translate it. But just the decision that C-3PO was built by Anakin, kind of strange. Then they would have had to make him seem like a droid that was built by a kid, not as polite, not as knowledgeable, but just as annoying. Let's go. No, the knights took Chewie.
Ray? Chewie?
Huh? Oh.
The Knights of Ren are so rude. Now this scene. Even though it's one of the most memorable and remarkable scenes from this film, the one where she was jumping up over the ship and smashing it on the way, I kind of refuse to believe that it's cool.
No!
No!
Oh.
Chewbacca can't die. Like, the Phantom wouldn't survive if Chewbacca dies. Poor stormtroopers.
Hello.
Hello.
It's alright. You're with us now.
No, thank you.
Chewie had the dagger. That was the only clue to the Wayfinder thing, and it's gone.
So true. The inscription lives only in my memory now.
Ah. In your memory?
Yes, Master. Mm-hmm.
I know a black market droidsmith.
A black market droidsmith?
He's Uncle
it's
Gene.
Better than Finn.